Every single member of my family on both sides was exterminated. Both of my parents were in the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. And it's precisely and exactly because of the lessons my parents taught me that I will not be silent when Israel commits its crimes against the Palestinians. And I consider nothing more despicable than to use their suffering and their martyrdom to try to justify the torture, the brutalization that Israel daily commits against the Palestinians. If you had any heart in you, you would be crying for the Palestinians.
Israel was born out of ethnic cleansing, but the genocide seems to be never ending. The Holocaust did not justify the land grab, the Nakba. Palestinians want their land back. There's British complicity in all this misery, but Churchill cynically wrote his own history, pushing Truman on red menace delusion. Blame Soviet Union for all the confusion of independence movements and revolutions, but these conclusions were lies and illusions. Still they took down our Benz in 54 after they got Mossadegh year before. In the name of anti-communism they dominated with terror campaigns, power consolidating, West installed dictators with clubs, civilians bleeding, murdered in cold blood. Economic war, there's no glory, killing the poor like a Tory. Armed robbery, Jack Glory, no democracy, memento mori.
Aren't you aware of our history? Isn't history taught in the classroom?
All the CIA plots and assassinations, consistent policy for all administrations. Your committee saying they're all aberrations, but that's just a system of indoctrination, manufacturing consent in the population. Fake proclamation when they bomb a nation, pass bowels bow to the new emperor, where every senator is bought by the treasurer. They locked down the planet after World War II, NATO, IMF, World Bank after you. So pay for independence or face vengeance, all the interventions, torture, detentions, Vietnam, Cuba, invasion, embargo, Lumumba, Mobutu, Sukarno, Suharto, Allende, Pinochet, the death ricochet. You got disappeared if you disobey.
What right do you have to do what you do in other countries?
We'll intervene whenever we decide it's in our national security interest to intervene. And if you don't like it, lump it. Get used to it. World
shock treatment to the shock doctrine. They made sure every country got locked in. Funded Bin Laden against the Soviets. Armed Saddam and his associates. Got Qasim then Iran post 79. British American leaders heavily lying. They always support despots in the Middle East, cause they beat the masses and keep the oil cheap. They don't want peace cause they export guns. They don't want justice, they extort funds. The arms economy runs government policy, so it's murder, robbery, further dishonesty. Business is war and war is business. You got resources, you're on the hit list. Saddam went rogue, you beat him but let him live. Then your sanctions killed half a million kids.
I mean, that's more children than died in Hiroshima. And you know, is the price worth it?